low and appear more intelligent and smart. But I'm stuck like a dog with a thing called home, and I can't get out of my heart. Not this heart.
Nice, Leah. Good job. This is another great song for you. So the good thing about this song, or it's the thing about this song that's a little different than the Sound of Music song, is that it's a little more belty, right? It's a little more upbeat and chesty, and that's what I wanted, was for you to have something that that showcased that part of your voice, okay? So where you're placing it is really lovely. It's very beautifully placed. When we get to the very end, let's see. But I'm stuck like a dope with a thing called hope. By the time you get to thing called hope, that's where I want you to start switching it to more of a little bit more of a heavy place. Where you ended it is perfect, but I think I'm just talking about the transition to getting there. Okay? Yeah. Because otherwise you have to reach a little bit and it feels like you're straining to get there. So let's go from bottom, but I'm stuck like a dope with a, and then remember, thing called hope is where you start to turn.
But I'm stuck like a dope with a thing called hope, and I can't get it out of my heart.
Yeah. And that tempo keeps up its speed. So, thing called hope, and I can't get it out of my heart. So, I would say, thing called hope, you made that transition to the heady space really beautifully. Don't let it slow you down too much. Okay, and after, you can cut hope short, so it can be a quarter note instead of half note, so that you can breathe and continue. Do you want to try from one more time, but I'm stuck?
But I'm stuck like a dope with a thing called hope, and I can't get it out of my heart.
Yes, just breathe after hope instead of can't.
Yeah.
You want to try one more time?
But I'm stuck like a dope with a thing called hope. Ah, sorry.
That's okay.
Can I have the note again?
Uh-huh.
But I'm stuck like a dope with a thing called hope, and I can't get it out of my heart.
Yes, yes. That'll take a little practice to get that breath in and to make that like muscle memory. But now the transition to the headier place is really well done.
Thank you.
Okay, does that feel a little more comfortable?
Yeah.
Good. Okay, so now let's talk about the words. Do you feel like you understand what she's saying mostly?
Sort of.
It's kind of hard, I know. So can we go through it line by line? I want you to read it to me. And if there's any part of it that you're like, I don't really know what she means,
let me
here,
tell get me. The sheet music.
Okay, sounds good.
When the sky is a bright canary yellow, I forget every cloud I've ever seen. Well, I'm not sure why she calls it canary yellow, because, like, the sky isn't yellow.
It's not. I think she means the sun. I think she means it's so bright from the yellow sun. Good question.
I forget every cloud I've ever seen, so they call me a cockeyed optimist, immature and incurably green. I don't really understand that either.
So they call me a cockeyed optimist, meaning, do you know what optimist is?
Yeah, I get that part. It's just I don't understand why they call her incurably green.
Incurably green. So green, in this situation, refers to she's naive. Do you know what that means?
Yeah.
She doesn't pay attention to the reality of life. She just thinks everything is happy.
Yeah.
Incurably, meaning no one can help her. She's just going to be happy no matter what.
Yeah.
Okay.
I've heard people rant and rave and bellow that we're done and we might as well be dead, but I'm only a cockeyed optimist and I can't get it into my head. I hear the human race is falling on its face and hasn't very far to go, but every whippoorwill is selling me a bill and telling me it just ain't so. I don't understand what the whippoorwill part is.
every just essentially in this case she's just saying every person, every naysayer, every negative person is telling me that this that we live in this terrible world.
But every whippoorwill is selling me a bill.
It's selling me this idea that the world is terrible and humans are falling apart.
And telling me it just ain't so.
Telling me it just ain't so. Your belief that this world is a happy, good place isn't true.
Oh, okay. I could say life is just a bowl of jello and appear more intelligent and smart, but I'm stuck like a dope with a thing called hope and I can't get it out of my heart. Not this heart.
Yeah. So she's essentially saying, I wish that I could just open my eyes and see the reality, but no matter what, I'm always going to see the glass half full. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
So the reason I wanted you to go through that text, and thank you for asking me your questions, is because that's the only way we can really start acting it and enjoying it. So this character is like larger than life, Nellie. She's like, when the sky is a bright canary yellow, I'm so happy, I just can't believe it. You know what I mean? So when you're singing it, let that influence your singing a little more. And
okay.
It can be a little more fun. Okay? Do you want to try it one more time?
Sure.
With the piano? Okay. Thank you. This would be another great audition song if you want to showcase more of your chesty